Hello and welcome everyone to this Docker Cloud Quick Start. Today we're gonna launch again the example voting app. So in a nutshell, for the people who aren't familiar with this one, with this application, is the application that we also used in the previous demo. It's very simply a very modern application stack with five applications that are very loosely coupled. So there's two front ends, a voting app in which you can vote on two choices, and on the other end, the business side of things, let's say the result app in Node.js. Both have a data backend. The result app stores gets its information from a Postgres database. Votes that are cast in a voting app will go on a Redis queue. And in between, there's a .NET worker that will get the votes from the Redis queue and push them into the Postgres database. I'm going to go in the Docker Cloud interface, so I'm already logged in. So we'll see here that there's a couple of entities in Docker Cloud. You link your account to a certain provider, so as I said, AWS, DigitalOcean, and so on. From there, you create nodes in a node cluster, so those are the instances, the servers that run underneath. So services is a group of containers, and many services, they form a stack, and you can link repositories to automatically deploy applications. And so here you can see, okay, in the node cluster, I'm gonna create a cluster. I can bring my own node. So basically, when you already have your resources running, what you can do is install a Docker Cloud agent on those servers, on those instances, and they will get picked up in this UI. But since that's already a little bit more advanced, we're gonna go the easy way, and we're gonna create everything out of the box from the UI. So I'm gonna click create over here. Gonna name my my cluster. Gonna name that one production. Then here under provider, as you can see, many providers, I already linked AWS. So I'm gonna click that one in region EU, US East 1. All right. And then I can pick things that already exist, or just leave it all automatically. So Docker Cloud will create everything for me. So VPC, I'm not gonna pick one, just gonna let Docker Cloud do its thing. I choose a type of instances, gonna go for micro instance. No IAM role for now. Disk size can be a bit lower, let's say 20 gigabytes. For redundancy, I want 3 nodes. So gonna launch my node cluster. All right, so this took about 5 to 10 minutes, but now our entire node cluster production is ready with 3 nodes over here, all the settings I've given it. You can see a timeline of when it was created and what happened during the deployment. So no stacks yet. So let me go into the code, because next to a Docker Compose file, you can also define a Docker Cloud file. So it's very comparable to a Docker Compose file with just a couple of extra settings possible. So we have RDB, Redis, result app, vote app, and worker, and a load balancer, which I'll get into a minute. So I go under stacks and I create a stack. Just get this nice editor over here. I copy paste my two services and I give it a name. Vote app, and I go create and deploy them. So again, you'll get this nice UI, which will show you that things are happening, the stack is starting, and two services are defined and are booting up. Okay, so that went pretty fast, about a minute. So now I have a DB service running and a Redis service. If we go into one, we go into the detail of the service, as you can see over here, with some basic settings, the containers, but I only defined one container for each service, containers that are running, DB1, no endpoints because I don't expose anything to the outside world, triggers, links, and so on. We'll get into that when we launch the other applications. All right. Now, I'd like to start the voting app. So, I go to my stack again, stack of the vote app. I, of course, want to edit that and add an extra application. So, I'll add this from the Docker Cloud YAML file from the image Docker and example voting app vote latest, open port 80 to the public, restart it, and I want three containers. I can save that. All right, my UI tells me that it's only partly running because the vote app is defined but not yet deployed. So what I'm gonna do is start this, and you'll see this breathing, and in a couple of minutes the vote app will be deployed on my nodes, and that's done. So when I go over here, I see information about my node, open port or published port 80, auto restart always, a couple of things I said. My containers, so I set to launch three, which it did, vote one, vote two, and vote three. Some information about these containers over here. Go in the containers view then. And yeah, this tells me that there's an endpoint opened. So for this particular container of the voting app, it's this endpoint. Pretty familiar for the people who saw the earlier demos. So this is the voting app, cats and dogs, running on container ID vote one. Very nice, but obviously this is only one container. And I launched three, and I want my visitors to be load balanced to this three containers. So we're gonna add yet another service. And just to show you that it doesn't necessarily have to be always defined in a YAML file, I'm just gonna use the UI. So I'm gonna create an extra application. So I'm gonna need a load balancer, which is provided by the Docker Cloud team in the form of a HA proxy. So I'm gonna click that. Okay. Service name, gonna rename that to LB load balancer. Gonna add that to the vote app stack. Just one container is fine. Deployment strategy, depending on your needs, in this case MTS node, so there's a nice balancing, but you can launch it on every node should you want to. No specific deployment constraints. You could define certain tagging systems over here to launch, for instance, databases on instances that you labeled as SSD, for instance. Not going to do that over here. Auto restart always. No auto destroy. I do have to give this service full access to the Docker Cloud API because it needs to pull my stack and see where certain services, in this case the voting app, is living, what its variables and parameters are. So I'm going to give it full access. Now it's going to change the basics. I could set memory limits and CPU limits, but I don't need those for now. And then a very important thing, exposing the ports. So it already picked the exposed port from the container image file. But in our particular case, I just want port 80 to be opened to the outside world. And I'm gonna make it public also on port 80. And then I wanna obviously link this to a particular other service namely the Vote app. Adding that. So the link is Vote with alias Vote. And by doing that, a couple of extra environment variables were added into this launch configuration about the Vote app. All right, now I create and deploy everything. And you'll see that my load balance service is also launching and by now already running. One container as defined. And now you can see over here, my container exposes endpoints, but there's also a service endpoint, like an open to the world endpoint that you can see over here. I will launch that one. And now when I refresh this a couple of times, at one point you'll see now is Vote 3, Vote 2 over here. So every time I refresh, I get load balanced to a certain container in my Vote app stack. So when I look at that in the stack, the Vote app with an extra load balancer over here, here are all the container endpoints that are published and the service endpoint over here for my voting app. So when I launch that now and I click it, we'll see that it's already working in the sense that my vote is being registered and pushed into the Redis queue, but obviously there's no result app or worker yet. So now we go on and launch the result app. So in stack, I'm gonna edit my vote app stack again. Add yet another node. You see load balancer over here. So I launched that through the UI, but it was added to my cloud file. And now I'll add the result app with very similar settings to the Vote app. Save it. And we can see it over here that it was added. Again, my stack is partly running because the result app is not yet started. So let's start it up right now. And it is started. So the result app has just one container and immediately opens up port 8080, publishes port 8080 to the outside world as a service endpoint. So when I go over there, we see the result app. For now, no votes registered. So an even 50-50%. So both my voting and result app are working, but now they need to exchange their information, and that's what the worker comes in for. So one last time, we go to our vote app and edit the stack, add a new application, the worker, and there we are. This took a little bit longer, about a minute, 2 minutes, because the worker image is a little heavier to load. But we have three workers nicely running. So now when we go to our voting app and we vote for cats, then we'll see in the result app that it's nicely changing. Let me open that in a incognito window to fake another user, go to the vote app, also a cat person. If we then go into the result app, we'll see that two votes are cast and cats is still at 100% because everyone voted cats. And now our business wants a new version of the application and wants to do a sci-fi poll. So, As a developer, I went into the code and changed a couple of things. And now I want to deploy a new version of this application. So what I could do is go into the stack, edit the stack, and I just want to change the Vote app. I made my own version on my own repository. and it's called My Vote App on tag sci-fi. All right, I'm gonna save that. Okay, and now I'm just gonna redeploy. And as you can see, the three old containers have been shut down and three new ones have come up. The endpoints, container endpoints have changed. So in my stack, when I now go to the load balancer, you'll see that our poll has been updated to Star Wars and Star Trek. That's it for this demo. Just want to show that it will integrate very nicely with your already existing AWS account. So as you can see over here, it created instances for me, didn't have to do anything with VPC, security groups, and all that stuff. All right, thank you very much for watching this demo. If you liked it, please subscribe and leave a like, and let me know in the comments what other tools, services, things in the Docker ecosystem you want to learn more about. See you next time.